So, as I said, the title of the story, Homecoming, seems to suggest some sort of separation and reunion. So, there is a streak of sadness and pain that runs as an undercurrent throughout the story. Here, the boy, the protagonist, a 14-year-old boy, he longs to come back to his house because after his father's death, his mother found it very difficult to run the family. And this boy, at the age of 14, he was a mischievous boy, and his mother couldn't control him. And his mother sends the boy Fatik along with her brother to Calcutta, and there he finds it very difficult to adjust with city life because the boy is basically from a village. Till the age of 14, he was having a very good life in his village, and suddenly when he was taken to city, he finds it very difficult to adjust with city life, and he longs to come back to his home. And what happens, whether he comes back to his house or whether he stays continues to stay with his uncle, that is the story about. So this is perhaps actually the story. Homecoming is a reflection of the personality of Rabindranath Tagore himself, who occasionally used to have bouts of depression. So this we can say a somewhat autobiographical story, because Tagore himself, he had all these problems. So while he was growing, you know, he did not get very good attention from his parents. Tagore could not receive the full-time attention of his parents during his growing years. His mother had already died, while his father, Devendranath Tagore, traveled widely during the Indian National Movement. So he was very much involved in the Indian National Movement, that is Tagore's father, and he could not give good attention to his son. And Tagore, he badly missed his father's, attention or care. And here the boy, Fatik, also has the same problem. All this meant isolation for young Tagore, who grew up lonely from within. And this particular story, Homecoming, begins against the backdrop of a rural setting in a village nearby Calcutta. So as I said, the setting or the background of the story is a village. The protagonist, his name is Fatik Chakravarti, is carrying out acts of mischief with his friends. So he is a mischievous boy because he is just 14 years old. He enters into a quarrel with his younger brother Makan. And one fine day after that quarrel, he finds a boat carrying a middle-aged man with grey hair and dark moustache. And the man asks Fatik the whereabouts of Chakravarti. But what the boy did, the young boy, he refuses to give a proper answer to the man's question. And later the man discovers that, later the boy, Fatik, discovers that the man is none but his maternal uncle, Bishamba, that is, the man is his mother's brother, and he is from Calcutta. And Bishamba, that is his uncle, Fatik's uncle, stays happily with Chakravarti for some days. So he stays, that is, his uncle stays with the family for some days. And after staying with the family, he comes to know about Fatik. He learns that he is very difficult for his sister to manage Fatik. So after some days, he offers to take Fatik with him to Calcutta for his education. Because finding that it's very difficult for his sister to handle the boy alone, he consoles, that is, Bishamba consoles his sister, saying that, "Don't worry, I will take Fatik with me to Calcutta and I'll give him good education." So Fatik was very happy, because he is going to leave the village and he is going to live a very good, comfortable life in Calcutta. This is what he thought. So Fatik's joy knows no bounds. Before leaving, he ensures to make peace with his brother Makan and gives him his toys, fishing rod, kite and